Hey guys, welcome back to Secret Garage. Today we are fixing again. Anyway, first of all, thank you very much for everybody who subscribed actually. 325 subscribers at the moment. If you subscribe, thank you very much. If you didn't, just subscribe. And the air conditioning is not working and we have close to 40 degrees and it was unbearable in the car, so we fix it now. So that's how it looks at the moment. You see we have a fault code in the air conditioner, and when you go in, let's see. Yeah, so fault code is the pressure sensor low, and if we go back and we actually have a look on the data from this sensor, which will be that, you can see that it's showing us 3.26 megapascal, which is, yeah, this is that, this is here. So seems like the sensor is just directly putting out 5 volt, so it's probably shorted inside or something like that. We will try to figure it out. The higher the voltage, the higher the pressure. And I actually back probe at the sensor and I measured the voltage on the middle pin, and the voltage was 5 volts, so I assume it's the incoming 5 volt, it's actually shorted to the signal. So I always have a 5 volt going through the sensor, which means that my computer thinks that everything is totally charged up and there is absolutely high pressure in the car, and that's why it's not engaging the clutch from the compressor. Now we know that the compressor is not engaging, the clutch is not engaging, the stuff is not turning. I was thinking about it for some time and I realized that actually to check if the actual sensor is the problem, I could try to simulate the signal of the sensors. We are using 2 1 kilo ohm resistors, and that should give us around 2.5 volt outgoing signal back to the computer, and this way we will kind of simulate different state of the pressure sensor. I hope I explained it right. Yeah, so that's pretty much what we are doing now. I will show you the contraption I make to trick computer into reading the proper signal. So it's just 2 resistors, one in the left, one in the right, and both in the middle. So in the middle we should have something around 2.5 volt. Okay, so we need to reconnect to the computer. That sometimes happens, so you need to exit and then enter again. I don't know why, but it's always like that. So here, and you can see we have 1.5 megapascal, 1.5 megapascal, so we should be somewhere around here. Oh, sorry. So what I want to do now, actually, I put this contraption there inside with these 2 resistors, and now I'm waiting for my beautiful wife to get here and assist me with pushing a button. So we will start the car and then we will turn on the air conditioner and we'll see if the clutch will engage. So friends, we have my wife assisting. We have a compressor, you see it's not turning. Well, let me just light it up good. Go on. Okay. So there we have it. That's our contraption there. Simulating sensor, perfect. So that will be it for now. I ordered the part. I already speak with my friend. We probably will need to let him do it because he can actually drain the AC and then change the sensor and put it back on, because I don't know if it's possible to change it without draining a sensor, and I probably don't want to risk it. Yeah, I will tell you how it goes when we have it fixed. Hey guys, back to the air conditioner. So I go to mechanic and he suck out all coolant or refrigerator, or you know what I mean, and
He gave it a shot with unscrewing the sensor. No success and no access. So I do it myself now. We'll see how it goes.
That's the sensor we're going for. It's here. So my approach is 19 to hold it on the bottom and 27 to unscrew the sensor.
Now is this a perfect team or what?
I will just verify the rotation. So there is no funny left thread, right thread stories. Let's have a look. Yeah, just totally normal. Right in, left out. Let's go for it. Left out. So, this. They already tell me that they give it a little bit of a turn, so I don't want to do any more. Yeah, awesome access, big car, lot of space. But you can, what do you want more than that, right? Yep, that's not going to happen. This one, maybe. Oh, take a look. How bloody easy it was. Boom. There you go. Something is leaking. Very little something. Maybe there is a valve. Nobody really knows if there is a valve. There is a vacuum. That's what I'm sucking actually. Yep. There was something. But it was very little something. Good, so we put the new one in. New O-ring is there. So now just don't drop it there. And that's... So that's all it takes to do. So simple. The hardest thing here is actually approaching this. Rest, it's bloody easy. It would be nice to have like a hop chopped. It's hard to feel the... Yeah, I would say it's fine. And there you see it. You see, that's the guy. New one on. That's the old one. Yeah. Looks exactly like a new one, just dirty. Anyway, so we will fill it up and then we see if it works. So, see you maybe tomorrow. I hope. Hi guys, another day. We are back from the workshop and we have a very good result. We put the refrigerant in the system. 850 gram, it's in the tolerance. Actually, according to manual, we should put 870, but somehow we missed 20 grams. So anyway, the result is very good. We are pushing air in with temperature around, I don't know, minus 13 was it when we check it. You probably saw it in the video already or in the short maybe. So yeah, that's it. We changed the sensor and now it's nice and cozy, or actually it's nice and cold inside. I hope it helped you to deal with the issue, maybe if you have, or at least show you how you can diagnose it yourself in case you have a problem with the AC in your car. And thank you for tuning in and we see us in the next video. Cheers.